start by asking about Ross Barkley. How's he settled in, and could he possibly feature tomorrow night?
I know, tomorrow night, I think it's very soon. It's very soon for him. But we must be pleased because his physical condition is good. And he has started to have the transition with us to understand our idea of football. I think that we must be pleased. And but he needs a bit of time, and he's a bit of time to work under physical aspect, under tactical aspect. But I think that his condition is good. It's very good.
Do you have an idea when he might play?
I don't know. Now it's very difficult to say this. But at the same time, I'm very positive. I'm very positive because the player is a good guy. He's showing great will to work, great desire to help us very soon. And I think this is very, very positive. And I'm very happy to have Ross with us for the rest of the season.
What's your selection policy for this game now? It's the semi-final. How strong a team will you play, and how strong an Arsenal team do you expect to face?
I think that in every game we have to try to make a strong team, and if you play in the league, if you play in FA Cup, if you play in Carabao Cup, I think when you play every 3 days, and it's important to make the rotations, but at the same time your team must be very strong, because otherwise you risk to drop in this trophy. And tomorrow there is another important game for us. This is a semi-final of Carabao Cup. This is a trophy, and I think we deserve to stay here and tomorrow to play the game against Arsenal.
What do you think about playing the game with a video assisted referee?
As you know very well, in Italy, from the start of this season, they are doing this. I think this is a good opportunity to improve our football, but at the same time, it will be very important to have a bit of time to use in the right way this new option. But I'm sure that I'm positive. I'm positive because when there is a big mistake, it's right to try to correct this mistake.
I have to ask you, Antonio, there has been this war of words between yourself and Jose Mourinho, who you spoke again at the weekend. Do you regret that it's come to this point, and do you regret anything you have said about him?
I have this look, a person that regret. I don't think so. Yeah, but I think we both said the things, and we'll see what happens in the future.
Have the League Managers Association or anyone at the club spoken to you about this, hoping that you can sort it out between the two of you?
It's not important, the association, you understand? It's not important. I think that he said serious words. He used the serious words, and I won't forget this, you understand?
Just one last on this. For the reputations of these two great clubs, though, must it be sorted out before the two teams meet again?
Yeah, but this is not a problem from the club. This is a problem between me and him. I stop.
Okay. Martin.
Hi, Antonio. Simple question about the injuries. Eden Hazard missed the game at the weekend. We noticed that he was a little bit injured. Is he okay for selection? And is anybody else a doubt because of injury?
No, Eden is in a good fit. Yeah, he's in a good physical condition. He recovered from this little problem in his calf. Yeah, he's ready. He's in contention for tomorrow's game.
Nobody else?
No.
Please.
First of all, can I ask about transfers? Because you've been linked with West Ham striker Andy Carroll quite a bit. I mean, is that a player you're interested in? I mean, when I've seen your teams before, you always like playing a big striker.
As you know very well, because as I said before, the club knows very well which are the position that we can improve. I repeat, I'm very happy. I'm very happy to work with my players, and I'm very happy for the commitment of my players. Then now there is a transfer market. If there is the possibility to find a good solution to improve the squad, I think the club knows very well which are my opinion.
I mean, you give Batshuayi quite a few chances, and the latest one at the weekend against Norwich, but he doesn't seem to have scored the number of goals that maybe you would have liked or Chelsea fans would have liked.
Batshuayi is a young player. Batshuayi is a player that he has a good future in front of him. He has to continue to work in this way, to have this commitment. And for sure, it's not simple. It's not simple to be young and to play in a great team like Chelsea. But I'm very happy for his commitment. I'm very happy for his behaviors during the training session. I'm very happy when he's playing, when I'm calling him to start the game. He has to continue this way.
Last week's league game was one of the best games seen for a long time between you and Arsenal. Do you see the semi-final, the two-legged semi-final, being similar to last week or more like the game at the Bridge earlier in the season, which was a lot more tense?
I don't know. For sure, the last game was an exciting game, especially for the people who watched the game. Yeah, I think also tomorrow the game will be very, very open, because I think both teams want to try to win, want to try to attack. And when you have the two teams that they think the same things, and for sure you can have an exciting game also tomorrow, I hope. I hope to have a good result, because this is the first game and we are playing at home, and then there is another game away. Yeah, we want to try to do our best. We want to try to reach the final in this competition. But at the same time, I think Arsenal wants to do the same.
Yeah, last one from me on Arsene Wenger. I mean, he's under a lot more pressure going into this semi-final than you are. His team just got beat by Nottingham Forest 4-2. Do you admit that he's under more pressure to win than you are?
No, but we are talking about a team, about a manager that they won a lot. They won a lot in the past. I don't think he has a lot of pressure only because they lost the game against Nottingham Forest. In England, during this trophy and in this trophy, anything can happen. And as you know very well, last season in the second round we were eliminated from West Ham. And this season now we are in the semi-final, Carabao, and in FA Cup, and we have to play another game against Norwich. As I said before, it's very difficult. It's very difficult. Every game is not easy. If you play with with a good team, with a medium team, or a low team.
Okay, yes.
I found that this competition was used by managers over the years to give chance to young players. When you reach a semi-final in this competition, do you change this philosophy? You want to go to the final, or you will still give chance to second-tier players?
I think from the start of the season, we tried to find a good balance, and to give the right opportunity, the right chances to everyone. Because I think every my player deserves to have the chance to play. And in this case, for sure, this competition, it was important for us because we played a Carabao's game with a young player, but at the same time, we played with a strong team. Because our run in this competition wasn't easy. In the second round we played against Everton. In the third round we played against Bournemouth, and now against Arsenal. But at the same time, we must be very happy because we reached the semi-final. Tomorrow is another opportunity to make rotations. Compared to last game, yeah. But we want to try to do our best. We want to try to win. We want to try to reach the final.
One last one for me. You mentioned the video assistant referee has been used in Italy this season. From what you have from there, what lessons can be learned from the Italian experience in England?
At the start. It wasn't been easy to accept this type of solution, and sometimes to stop the play and to wait the right decision from the VAR, no? And but I think this could be a good solution because you reduce the mistakes in especially big mistakes, and I think it's right for football to have a game with less mistakes.
Liam.
In the last game against Arsenal, the 2-2 draw, Mesut Ozil was particularly good, and he seemed to find quite a lot of space in between the lines to cause the Chelsea defence problems. So, can you see yourself changing anything about your strategy for tomorrow to stop that happening?
No, I think the game against Arsenal was a good game. I think our performance was very good, but we know very well which are the point of strength of this team, and maybe. Where they have the point, the weak points. Yeah, I think that we tried to study the game in the right way, and we want to play another good game. We want to try to play and to win the game, but for sure we must pay great attention because we are talking about a great team, about a big team. Arsenal is one of the six top teams in England, and we must pay great attention tomorrow.
Okay, Nizar.
Antonio, I just wanted to ask you about Eden Hazard. He had a kick on his calf. Is he better for this game that's coming up?
Yeah, he's available for this game. Yeah.